When your family's in need of medical care, where should you turn? Come to Englewood Hospital, home of the most advanced technologies and medical equipment. Home to Magnet Award-winning nurses who deliver compassionate professional care. And home to more top-rated doctors than any other hospital in North Jersey. For your family's health, come to Englewood Hospital. We're closer than you think.
Welcome to Dr. Gore's show. I am so pleased to have Dr. Richard D'Amico again on the TV show. And today we're going to talk about advances in liposuction and anti-aging treatment. It's a very interesting talk, so stay tuned. Dr. Richard D'Amico did his medical schooling at NYU. Then he went to do surgery residency at University of Rochester. And he came back to New York at Columbia to do his fellowship in plastic. He is a past president of American Society of Plastic Surgeons. He is a clinical associate professor at Mount Sinai. And presently, he's the chair of Plastic Surgery Regenerative Task Force. And he's been in practice in New Jersey for more than 20 years, helping women look better, and men too. So welcome to Dr. Gore's show, Dr. D'Amico. It's my pleasure to have you back.
It's my pleasure to be back, Dr. Gore. Thank you for having me.
So, you know, liposuction, it's been going on for a long time.
Yes.
And it has its advantages to kind of lose fat in a controlled fashion, relatively over a short period of time. But as medicine evolves, things get better and better. So let's talk about basically what's a liposuction and how things have evolved in the last few years.
Sure. Well, I think most people know that liposuction is not a way to lose weight.
Correct.
So if somebody is really overweight, they need to do the basic things of diet and exercise.
Right. There are no shortcuts.
There's no shortcuts. Now, having said that, liposuction is best to deal with localized collections of fat.
Mm-hmm.
In women, it's usually around the tummy.
Mm-hmm.
It can be the hips, the saddlebag areas, the
right.
inner thighs, these localized areas. Now, they can be critical to restoring appearance.
Right.
So this is very helpful. So in terms of how we get rid of this unwanted localized fat, there are different ways we can do it.
Right.
There's the non-invasive methodologies, which don't involve liposuction.
Okay.
For small areas, we have technologies like using cold, known as cool sculpting,
okay.
where we can take a roll of fat
mm-hmm.
and we treat it with two cold plates while you sit there.
Okay.
And when we do that, the fat that's between the cold plates will go away 25%. Not 75%, not 100%. So it's improvement.
Okay.
And if that works well and the patient likes it, we can do it again.
Okay.
So for modest fat reduction in certain areas, particularly the abdomen,
mm-hmm.
this is good.
Okay. There's
no pain, no anesthesia, no downtime, no recovery.
Right.
There's also treatments that will take care of some fat just underneath the skin.
Okay.
The so-called venous freeze type technologies,
okay.
which can be done both in the body
mm-hmm.
And also in the face.
So like the double chin you have.
The double chin, even sometimes, we don't like to take much fat away from the face,
right.
but it also will allow some skin tightening
right.
and just a tiny bit of superficial fat reduction.
Okay.
But for anything more than that,
mm-hmm.
and particularly in women who want to really optimize their appearance,
right.
they want to be sculpted,
correct.
Then we need liposuction.
Okay.
So over the years, what we've done is we've developed what I would call a kinder and gentler liposuction.
Okay, that's a nice way to put it.
It is, and it works. It's called Hydrosolve.
Okay.
And it's a water-based technology, as the name implies.
Right.
So what we do now is we make a very small opening, usually 2 to 3 millimeters.
Wow.
A very tiny opening. So it's really minimally
mm-hmm.
invasive.
Right.
We put a very narrow tube in.
Mm-hmm.
And then we put some fluid in the tissues to make things nice and soft and to limit any blood loss.
Okay.
And the real engineering marvel is that inside this tiny cannula, There's a cannula, a tube, mm-hmm. that sprays warm, low-pressure water.
Okay.
So that when the fat gets near the cannula, mm-hmm. there's a hole in the cannula, and the fat gets taken down into the cannula just by the stream of warm water.
Right.
So there's no cutting. There's nothing sharp. It's a very gentle. It's almost like letting warm water run on a chicken that you're cleaning in the kitchen, and right. the skin slides away. It's a very gentle methodology. Mm-hmm. So there's less bruising,
right.
there's less blood loss, and that usually means a short recovery time.
Correct. And it's a little bit safer too, right? Because there's less amount of blood loss.
Yes, exactly. So we can take a larger amount of fat with mm-hmm. less implication, less risk, more safety.
So hemodynamically, blood loss-wise, the patient is safer.
It's negligible. Correct. It's negligible. So this is very exciting. It's a time when people can come in and get significant body contouring, mm-hmm. significant body contouring to help them. And while they don't lose the weight this way,
correct.
When your contour is dramatically improved, it's a little easier to stay on the treadmill longer.
Absolutely.
It's a little easier to pass up dessert or all those carbohydrates that we're not supposed to eat.
Correct. So I think, as we had discussed in our last show, the mummy makeover,
yes.
that even though sometimes you diet, you exercise, there are certain areas which sometimes are harder to lose weight, and those focus areas where your expertise come in, like that little bit, on the tummy, you have that fold, the panniculus, all yes. those areas. I think this is amazing. That amount of blood loss is so minimal, and the recovery time is easier. So that's exciting.
Yes, it is. It means we can do more for people right. with less recovery, less pain, less downside, and really, I think people should think of liposuction these days mm-hmm. as a body contouring,
correct.
A body sculpting procedure
right.
that's really minimally invasive.
Right.
Terrific.
And what is other newer techniques that one can use along with this, the venous, flow, the cooling things? Are there special areas that they can be used more than, say, like the buttocks area, or we spoke about the stomach area,
yes.
but is there any special areas that they can be used, like thighs and buttocks?
There are different size heads in mm-hmm. the cool sculpting device depending on certain areas.
Okay.
So the flanks or mm-hmm. hips, particularly in men,
right.
because men don't want any pain at all and can never tolerate any recovery time. So it's particularly good for them. But it works in men and women.
Mm-hmm.
But the key to the completely non-invasive technologies is that they are not 100% effective. They're 25 to 35% effective.
And can this be done again? So because it's 25%, it might go back, and do the people come back, and how safe it is to keep repeating it?
Yes. Well, it's perfectly safe to repeat it.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, it's 25% the second time. So that's not 50%.
Correct.
That comes down to about 33
right.
or a third. But definitely that's one way to approach it. So if you have no downtime,
mm-hmm.
then you can't even spend 3 days recovering. Because the average recovery from liposuction now is 3 to 5 days. That's all.
Wow.
That's all. But if you have no time for that, we can do the cool sculpting for you, and you can repeat that 2 or 3 times with no negative effect.
Right.
So it works
just like
well.
You come in like a tanning salon. You come in the morning, you go home, and then you can repeat it in every few
yes.
months.
The cool sculpting requires 1 hour
mm-hmm.
for each area that
mm-hmm.
you're treating. So if you treated the tummy and then both hips, that would mean staying for 3 hours. Yes.
Okay.
But you can work on your computer, watch TV. We have patients who fall asleep and rest.
Amazing.
Yes.
While you take a nap, you come out of looking a different person altogether.
Well, I don't know how different, but you certainly look better.
That's great.
You look better.
That's
absolutely
great. And is there anything advances in the horizon in liposuction as far as anything new happening?
Well, I think the holy grail that we would love in the future, as you know, there are two areas where the body keeps fat.
Uh-huh.
One is the peripheral area, and that's the fat that we all see and
correct.
Know. This is on the outside of the body, the tummy, the hips, mm-hmm. the thighs, even under the chin.
Right.
But there's a second depot of fat mm-hmm. that's inside the abdominal cavity. Mm-hmm. And the fat is packed around the intestines.
Omentum, right.
Yes, and the omentum. So if you think of a fish store, mm-hmm. the fresh fish, there's ice packed around the fish.
Right.
So if you opened up the abdomen in someone who's a little overweight, you would see the fat packed around the intestines.
Absolutely.
That fat we have not been able to get at directly. Mm-hmm. But someday, and I'm hoping it's in the next few years, well, that fat will be able to be also removed with liposuction.
Wow.
And that would be tremendously helpful because the fat on the inside.
With the oral cardiac health and
yes,
risk.
Yes, it's called visceral fat.
Right.
And it has all of the bad fat and
right.
all of the things that are bad for your health. It would also help diabetics and others
right.
where that kind of fat reduction actually would give you a health benefit.
Right.
So we're very excited about that, but this is not on the horizon.
Oh, absolutely, but it's amazing.
Guess.
It's amazing science for our kids to start thinking about.
Yes, I would guess 5 years for
wow.
that.
Wow, wow. So far we've talked about newer techniques for liposuction. There are smaller cuts, there's a very little downtime. There are different ways of taking care of this extra layers and at the localized areas. It's not a way of weight loss, but it's something as sculpting as Dr. D'Amico just said. We're going to take a short break and we'll be right back. Thank you.
When your family's in need of medical care, where should you turn? Come to Englewood Hospital, home of the most advanced technologies and medical equipment. Home to Magnet Award-winning nurses who deliver compassionate professional care. And home to more top-rated doctors than any other hospital in North Jersey. For your family's health, come to Englewood Hospital. We're closer than you think.
Welcome back to Dr. Gore's show. Today we have Dr. Richard D'Amico in the studio talking about advances in liposuction and anti-aging. Now going and talking about anti-aging, you know, as we get older, not only, you know, changes happen all throughout the body, but I think the first noticeable thing, especially for women, is their face. We get up in the morning and first thing, you're looking at your face and looking how many wrinkles and is it sagging, you know, the bags under your eyes, and that starts worrying you. Now, what is happening as far as the face care? Is there anything new, exciting? What's regenerative medicine? So let's talk about face.
Of course. I think let's explain aging,
okay.
if we can, for a minute. I can't cure it, but I can help it.
Right.
So let's talk about aging. We should think of the face like a sheet mm-hmm. and a mattress
okay.
on your bed. The skin is the sheet, mm-hmm. and everything inside the skin, the fat, the muscles, the bone, mm-hmm. is the mattress.
Okay.
So when we're young, the sheet fits the mattress, just
perfect.
Like one of those fitted sheets, everything's good.
Right.
As we get older, two things happen. The sheet or the skin gets looser, mm-hmm. and the mattress shrinks.
Okay.
And usually in the face, that's the loss of facial fat.
Okay.
So it's very important, even though we want to get rid of fat in our tummy, our hips, our saddlebags, mm-hmm. fat in the face is a precious commodity, and no one should ever remove fat from the face.
Okay.
By and large. We can remove it from the neck,
correct.
Under the chin, but not from the jawline up. The fat is precious.
Okay.
So let's talk about that combination. So restoring volume mm-hmm. basically means restoring fat.
Fat, right.
And if
we're talking opposite now.
Yes, we're talking opposite. Absolutely. Same tissue,
right.
but now we want it, and last time we didn't want it.
Correct.
And you can see some possibilities here.
Right.
What if we could move it from where we don't want it to where we need it?
Absolutely.
So, of course, this is plastic surgery, and we can do just that.
Right.
Okay? So what we'd like to do is transplant fat.
Mm-hmm.
And fat is not just a filler of space. It's mm-hmm. not just taking up space, which is important.
Right.
But it also has a nutritive effect.
Oh.
It makes the skin better by transplanting fat.
Okay.
And this is something that most people don't know or appreciate. So the best thing you can do for your skin is to transfer fat underneath that skin.
Right.
And it can be your own fat from another part of your body that you didn't want.
Right.
So this is very handy, very efficient.
Correct.
And it
it's
works.
Your own tissue.
And it's your own tissue. So the restoration of volume, it's just like a face being a blow-up doll.
Okay.
Aging is a slow leak. As the air comes out of the blow-up doll, she wrinkles.
Correct.
So the first step in facial rejuvenation may be to restore volume by putting fat in. And the, right now, the only fat we can put in a person's face is their own fat.
Sure.
Okay? There may come a day when we can put somebody else's fat material in. But right now, we need to use your fat, take it from where you don't want it, and put it in where we need it, in your face, to restore volume.
Okay.
That's called fat grafting or fat transfer.
Okay.
And it works.
And what about the skin, which has been
sagging? The skin is the other piece of the puzzle.
Right.
So if the fat is the mattress, the skin is the sheet, and the better they fit, the younger we look.
Right.
Because remember, everything we're discussing is restorative.
Absolutely.
We don't want to change you. This is very important.
Right. You don't want to look like somebody else.
No one wants to look like somebody else. And if they do, they need counseling, not surgery.
Right.
So remember that good plastic surgery is restoration, never alteration.
Oh, that's a very, very nice statement.
Very important. So in this restorative process, it would be best if we didn't let our skin get loose. But we don't do enough skin care from an early age.
Which is very important.
Very important. And I will tell you that younger people now have gotten the message. They're coming in younger and younger and doing smaller and smaller things.
Right.
If you wait too long, you end up in the operating room.
Right.
And we're happy to have you, but it's mostly not necessary.
Right.
So if we take care of our skin from the very beginning, while it still looks great, then you can keep it looking great.
Right.
And for the men out there, the analogy for this is washing and waxing the car. The paint will look good forever if you take care of it.
Right.
So let's talk about skincare.
Sure.
So skincare begins every morning and every evening at the sink.
Okay.
At home. That's the best skincare. It's what the patient does when she washes her face morning and evening. So there are certain products that are good for the skin, that hydrate the skin, and even abrade the skin a little bit.
Right, to take out the dead tissues and the cells.
Because when we're young, our skin cells are replacing themselves very quickly.
Correct.
Very quickly. It's called the turnover rate.
Right.
The young cells are pushing the old cells out, and the turnover rate is rapid. As we get older and older, it gets slower and slower.
Like our metabolism and the skin.
Yes. So in order to stimulate cell turnover, we have to stimulate the skin.
Correct.
So it can be washing your face with the right products.
Right.
That's the most important step. And then you come in and see the esthetician who can help you with some microdermabrasions, who can help you to stimulate the skin, to stimulate cell turnover, and simulate the young condition.
Correct. So the younger skin will look much brighter, much tighter, and, and will be fresh looking.
And we can keep it that way if we just do the maintenance.
Correct.
Okay. So it starts with skincare at home, and then you come in to see the esthetician every 3 or 4 months, and she'll do some microdermabrasions. We also have the needle techniques, where the needles make tiny micro holes, and in those holes it stimulates collagen and it keeps the skin thicker and younger and plumper. Okay, and so we can do these things. And by the way, all skin types can be helped.
Even the Indian skin.
Absolutely, the South Asian skin type. We call, we have a numbering system. Fitzpatrick 4, 5, and even Fitzpatrick 6, dark skin can be treated this way quite safely and without loss of pigmentation. So anti-aging is for everyone, regardless of skin pigmentation.
Okay, that's nice to know.
Yes. Now, not every treatment works on dark pigmentation.
Right.
But that's why we're here to take the treatment and fit it to the skin
you
that
customize
the patient has.
Correct.
Yes. Yes. So what's important is to treat the skin.
Okay.
So there are different ways of treating the skin.
Right.
So we've started with just washing your face with some products that are lightly abrasive. Then we're coming in to see the esthetician to do a little more abrasive things, but still lunch hour in and out. Then the next level up would be the needling technique, which, by the way, doesn't hurt.
Okay.
We put some topical Novocaine
anesthetic
gel. Exactly. And so we can do that, and you come out with just a little ruddiness to the skin. You get up, you go back to the office, can be done on your lunch hour. And if you do that five or six times a year, you can keep your skin in good shape. Now, there are people who have let their skin go, need more than maintenance. They need some restoration. For them, the laser is a wonderful tool.
To tighten the skin.
To tighten the skin.
Right.
So we treat the skin with the laser, and we use a fractional laser now, so it's gentler, which means less downtime.
Right.
But still there's downtime.
Of course.
So with really neglected skin and a really good laser treatment, you need a week off.
Okay.
So you, if the skin has been allowed to deteriorate, you have to invest the time.
And to fix it.
To fix it. But it can be done.
Right.
And so the laser is a wonderful modality. Now, if you don't have that week or that 5 days or 3 days, we can tune the laser. But if you don't, then we have the needling techniques. And we also have something called venous freeze for the face.
Right.
This is a radio frequency-based technology which generates heat deep in the skin and a little bit underneath the skin.
So below the dermis and...
So below the dermis, below the skin.
Right.
And it causes the deep skin to shrink.
And tighten it.
And tighten.
Very nice.
So if the patient is willing to come and make the effort, the maintenance effort, we can keep them from aging.
Wow.
So the younger you come in and the more regular you are with your treatments, then the less aging you're going to have.
And the less major surgeries and treatment you'll need.
We, our goal is to keep you out of the operating room.
Correct.
Now, at some point, if the skin is just so deteriorated and so stretched out from smoking and the sun, then we go into the operating room and we do the facelifting techniques.
Right.
Which require 2 weeks, a week to 2 weeks of recovery time.
Right.
It involves anesthesia, but we can take someone with heavy jowls, very loose skin, the big bands in the neck, and restore their contour, their shape, to the way it was when they were 40.
And they look a little bit younger because you're taking out the aging spots that, you know, the wrinkled skin around and the neck, which shows your age.
Yes.
I think you're taking care of that. You don't want to look them like 20 years old, but you want them to look, they have aged gracefully.
They look fresh.
Correct.
They look fresh. And the next time I come back, I'll bring you pictures of all this so we can show everyone photographs. We weren't able to do that tonight, but I think it's important at some point that we do that so they can see for themselves
the, before and
the befores and afters. Because it's important to know where you start before you evaluate the result.
Correct.
And that's really important.
Right.
So we see people now in their 70s and 80s who've neglected their skin.
Right.
We take them to the operating room if they're healthy.
Sure.
If they're healthy. And we can do these restorative procedures on them and give them, because 70 is the new 50.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, let's talk about the stem cell, because there's some role of adult stem cells in the plastic surgery world now.
Yes, very exciting, very exciting. So a couple of things.
Mm-hmm.
What is a stem cell?
Okay.
A stem cell is all over the human body.
Mm-hmm.
We have these cells that are not very specialized.
Right.
They're not eye cells, they're mm-hmm. not nose cells, they're not kidney cells.
Sure.
They're just cells that are waiting
mm-hmm.
to go and do good things around mm-hmm. the body. So if there's an injury to mm-hmm. a muscle,
mm-hmm.
the stem cells will go in
Correct.
And heal and make new muscle.
Right.
So it turns out that these very, very useful stem cells
mm-hmm.
are found mainly in mm-hmm. two places.
Okay.
One is inside your bone marrow.
Right.
And you can imagine it's very hard to get it out of there.
Right.
And it's painful, so mm-hmm. nobody wants that. And these are adult stem cells. Right. They're not embryonic cells.
Sure, but there's a controversy going.
So with adult stem cells,
mm-hmm.
there's no controversy.
Sure.
They're available for research. They're
mm-hmm.
available for treatment.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no ethical and moral
sure.
controversy.
Sure.
So it turns out the other place where there's lots and lots of stem cells
mm-hmm.
is your fat.
Really?
Yes. So that wonderful yellow tissue that we hate
mm-hmm.
is actually the best source of adult stem cells in the entire body.
Wow.
So in a quart or liter
mm-hmm.
of liposuctioned fat,
mm-hmm.
there's more than 1 million stem cells.
Wow.
Waiting to be useful.
And to regenerate into different tissue.
And to regenerate. So that's why the fat grafting that we did to the
okay.
face not only fills in the space, but actually gives a nutritional benefit to the skin.
Mm-hmm.
We think it's these stem cells that are acting in the area to be restorative and
wow.
regenerative.
Wow.
Hence the term regenerative medicine.
Right.
So there's some wonderful things with these cells.
It's very exciting field. And I think the future is going to take us and show us where we can go with these cells. But I think the time is running out, and we talked about advances in liposuction. We talked about regenerative medicine, which is now what we can do to make us look younger, not only on our face, but there's so much potential to use the stem cells, especially if it's coming from our fat. We can use our own fat, and as you suggested, maybe in the future, we might be able to use somebody else's fat, which is processed and safe to be used to other people. So I think
exactly.
Sounds amazing. Thank you so much for coming on Dr. Gorshow, Dr. D'Amico.
Pleasure.
Till next time, good night. And you can watch this show, especially tell your friends to watch it on YouTube, www.youtube.com, and you can go on Dr. Gorshow, and you'll be able to see our past shows as well as tonight's shows. Good night.
When your family's in need of medical care, where should you turn? Come to Englewood Hospital, home of the most advanced technologies and medical equipment. Home to Magnet Award-winning nurses who deliver compassionate professional care. And home to more top-rated doctors than any other hospital in North Jersey. For your family's health, come to Englewood Hospital. We're closer than you think.